Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
Be renewed in the spirit of your mind. So God says we have to be renewed in the spirit of our mind. Because a lot of times our people talk about that they're spiritual. To be the spirit, what is referring to is your mind. Our psychology is tore up. How did it become tore up? In slavery.
Bring it up.
When a master came in that slave shack and raped our women, our wives, that's mental trauma.
Teach.
All of this out here that you see on Pulaski is mental trauma. These are the results of mental trauma. PTSD.
That's right.
Read it again.
Teach.
And be renewed in the spirit of your mind. Because right now we're trying to renew our spirits with drugs, heroin, crack, weed, pills, alcohol, lean, but that don't renew us. Hoes, prostitution.
Right.
Read it again.
And be renewed in the spirit of your mind.
But we got to be renewed by the spirit of God. That's how we get renewed. Give me Deuteronomy 28 and 48. Let me show some more of that. We've been destroyed here in America. And that's what you need to learn. That's what you need to learn. That's what all of our people need to learn. And wake up out of this dead sleep. I see you right there listening. Come holler at me, bro. I'm your brother, man. Come check it out right quick, man. Read what you got.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 48.
Bring it up.
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
When do we serve our enemies?
All the time.
You see this sign right here? This is when we served our enemies, through slavery. Through slavery. Read, and we're still serving our enemies. Read.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
So God sent them against us. This was not white man and his pioneership and his entrepreneurship. So I'm going to go get me some niggas from West Africa. He didn't do that. God sent him against us.
That's
why?
Right.
Because we broke his commandments.
Right.
But how are we going to get out of here? When we repent and keep God's commandments.
Right.
Riddle.
In hunger and in thirst and in nakedness and in want of all things.
So anything that we want, we must serve this man. Who owns these grocery stores? If you want to get liquor and you want to self-medicate yourself, who do you go for? Your enemy. Read.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he have destroyed thee.
Who that happened to? To us, right? But read that last part again.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he have destroyed thee.
It says until he have destroyed thee. Right now we are destroyed. The reason why I wanted that is because it's showing our mental trauma. Our people are sick out here. We are not right in our minds. All right? We are not right in our minds.
Isaiah 1 and 5.
Exactly, exactly. Give me Isaiah 51 and 20. Let me go over that really quick. Let's go over some more of that. Mental trauma, PTSD, that's what we're going through because our people are sick. Some of us walking out here half naked, walking around in panties and just bras. That's a sick mind.
Teach.
Some of us out here leaning on the streets off a heroin, off a crack. That's a sick mind.
Teach.
And you think it's good. Some of you think these drugs are good for you. Some of you think gangbanging is good for you. Right. But it's not. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 51, verse 20. Uh-huh. Thy sons have fainted.
Meaning what? We lost that goddamn mind.
Right.
Bring it up.
God says his sons have fainted. Right. Read.
They lie at the head of all the streets.
And that's what we see right now. All of our sons hanging at the heads of all the streets. If you came out here an hour earlier ago, you'd have seen a whole lot of them. Because since the word of God came out, they ran away. Read.
As a wild bull in a net.
That's your game bangers. You can't tame a bull. So he's wilding out in the net.
They are full of the fury of the Lord.
God says they are full of the fury of the Lord. Meaning what? Because God is angry at us.
Read.
The rebuke of thy God. Therefore, hear now this, thou afflicted and drunken.
What did God say?
Therefore, hear now this, thou afflicted and drunken.
Therefore, hear now this, thou afflicted and drunken. Brother over here bringing out black power. It's Israelite power. or you're gonna die here in America. And I'm talking about you too. God ain't playing with us. We over here getting shot down in these streets, and y'all think it's all right? Get over here. Come learn the Bible. Come learn who you are according to God. Read.
Therefore, hear now this, thou afflicted and drunken.
Because our people are afflicted and drunken here in America. We've been oppressed. That's why you have so-called organizations, Black Lives Matters, that
get
exist. But guess what? That's a homosexual organization.
Oh, he got it. He got it.
But read on. Read on.
But not with wine.
But read on.
Thus saith thy Lord, the Lord thy God, that pleadeth the cause of this people.
Right now, God is pleading the cause of his people. That's why COVID-19 exists. That's why COVID-19 exists. The Lord God is judging these nations for slaving his people.
Right.
Believe it or not. That's why there's war going on in the Middle East, all over this world. But our people out here, they got nothing to do but sitting on drugs. Ain't even prepared for war. God is coming out here to deliver his people. Read.
Behold, I have taken out of thine hand the cup of trembling, even the dregs of the cup of my fury. Thou shalt no more drink of it again.
God says we shall no more drink of it again. This is our last captivity. America is prophesied to burn with nuclear fire.
That's right.
That's what is going on. And right now he has sent his prophets to deliver you. First, you have to repent and keep God's commandments, because he said all the sinners of his people shall die here if you do not repent. Burrito.
But I will put it into the head of them that afflicted thee.
That's why COVID-19 exists. That's why World War III is about to exist.
Right.
That's why all the world's, the wars is going on in the world. That's why all these heathen are scared. He's putting that cup of trembling into their hands.
Yes,
slowly
right.
But surely. Increments, increments. Read.
Which have said to thy soul, bow down.
Oh, whoa. I was getting a little deep. It said what?
Which have said to thy soul, bow down.
They said, nigga, bow down. You a nigga, get in them chains, boy. That's what they said. Bow down to our soul. Christ ain't black. He said Christ is a white man. Bow down. Become a Christian. Bow down, nigga. That's what he said to our souls. And we do it. That's why we oppressed and we strung out over here. That's why we think we ain't nothing. Read it again.
Bow down that we may go over. And thou hast laid thy body as the ground.
You see that? And we weighed our bodies as the ground. That's what you got Black Lives Matter talking about. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. If any other nation went through the things we went through, it'd have been a whole uproar.
Right.
It'd have been civil war in this country.
Right.
But we too damn scared because they beat the hell out of us. We know if we went to war with them, they would lynch our asses up left and right. You understand that? Read it again.
Which have said to thy soul, bow down, that we may go over. And thou hast laid thy body as the ground.
And we have laid our body as the ground because the Lord had put the spirit of fear. But the prophets are out here to raise you men back up.
Right.
The prophets of God are coming out here for the real men.
Right.
And if you want your women in order, you must get in order yourselves.
Right.
Read on.
As the street to them that went over.
Uh-huh.
Awake, awake,
read,
awake. Awake,
God says, awake, black man, awake, black woman, Hispanic man, Hispanic woman, read.
Put on thy strength, O Zion.
Who is that strength? The Almighty God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
That's the one
true God that delivered us from Egypt, that delivered us from Babylon, that delivered us from Cyrus, the Persian and the Medes, the Greeks, the Romans, and guess what? He's going to deliver us from America as well.
Read. Put on thy beautiful garments, O Jerusalem.
That's why you see us in these beautiful garments right here. We look good, don't we?
That's
we look damn good. Why? Because we got the spirit of the Lord on us.
Awake, awake. Put on thy strength, O Zion. Put on thy beautiful garments, O Jerusalem, the holy city.
God called us a holy people. We are a holy city, but right now we're not acting like it.
Right.
And that's what we out here for, to bring us back up and put it back in your spirit. We don't.
For henceforth there shall no more come into thee the uncircumcised and the unclean.
Because that's what's going on. Give me that, Isaiah 1 and 8. Give me Isaiah chapter 1 verse 8. Because it says, therefore no more shall the unclean come in unto us. They use and abuse us. That's why we chase after Republicans or Democratic parties.
Right.
Black Lives Matter. No, 1 verse 8.
Isaiah chapter 1 verse 8.
Bring it
and
on.
The daughter of Zion is left as a cottage in a vineyard.
Now let me ask you a question. What is a cottage in a vineyard?
Isaiah,
what happens to a cottage in a vineyard? You
straight,
go,
straight cut, straight to the point.
But you have people that go out into
that's
woods like camping or whatnot, right? You have? So what is that for? What is a cottage in the midst of a woods or a vineyard for? What's that for?
Usually it's for basically to camp out and stay go over there or open fields at the time.
Now is it yours?
No.
So anybody can come in there, right?
Yes, sir.
Let's see what God said.
And the daughter of Zion is left as a cottage in a vineyard.
So God relates to his people, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and natives, as a cottage that is in the midst of a vineyard, right?
As a lodge in a garden of cucumbers, as a besieged city.
So why does he say that? Because all nations just use and abuse us. They come and tell us, hey, you we mad at our man, you should be mad at your man too. That's what you got the feminist movement. That's what women out here talking about, we don't need no man. I'm independent. Whenever it comes for the other nations movement or whatever agenda they want to push, then they come for our people. When they want the black vote, when they want to get involved in office, they come for our people. When they want rights, gay rights, they want to come for our people. We are used and abused. Every nation comes in and out of us, and then they kick us off to the core like a damn $5 hole. That's how they use our people. Read on.
Except the Lord of hosts had left unto us a very small remnant, we should have been as Sodom, and we should have been like unto Gomorrah.
Do you know anything about the history of Sodom and Gomorrah?
No, sir.
Okay. Sodom and Gomorrah were two main cities, but it was a compass of five major cities, all right, and around in the land of Canaan. The main sin that God destroyed them for was for homosexuality. You understand that? Now, what's the main movement that's being pushed out here in America?
LGBT.
The alphabet group, right? The alphabet group. Now, before the alphabet group gained their, what's the word I'm looking for? Their status or their power, what were things that was taken, what were measures that were taken, put in the world before they gained their power? There was even TV shows out.
Like the New Wave situation, it's so.
Okay.
They promoted that. As a black nation, have you ever noticed that on TV, most gay people that's on TV are black?
Uh-huh. Exactly.
Take it. Then they try to promote it, say, oh, this is okay for our young men, which is not.
Absolutely.
It's
correct.
Not okay
absolutely
for our young correct African men to say, oh, I'm gonna wear this coat. Uh-huh. That's not okay.
Absolutely. So what I wanted to get at was first they introduced it into movies. Then they introduced it into TV shows. Then they came out with a saying, gay is the new black. As if gay or homosexuality is a thing for black people. When in actuality, the most homosexuals was the white man here. Those were the main homosexuals. But in order to push gay rights, they said, well, gay is the new black. And you know what? It's actually a civil right. And in fact, since we have civil rights, we should push this under the banner of civil rights, and we need all you black and Hispanic folks to push it. But what did God say?
Except the Lord of hosts and left unto us a very small remnant.
This is the very small remnant that you're looking at right now. These Israelites that you see on YouTube, those are the very small remnant. Read.
We should have been as Sodom, and we should have been like unto Gomorrah.
You know what God is prophesying right here? That their agenda is gonna have a major effect on the world. This homosexuality that you see going on in this world is going to increase. Everybody is gonna be damn near gay. Everybody is gonna be out here damn near transgender. You already can hardly tell which one is a man or a woman. And they demand a respect. They demanding that thing. They willing to get you fired for that thing. They got politicians pushing that thing. That's what Black Lives Matter is about.
The whole
organization is funded by the white man. And we're the last race to accept it. To accept homosexuality.
Hear the word of the Lord, ye rulers of Sodom.
Hear the word of the Lord, ye rulers of Sodom. Guess what? God has LGBT, the alphabet group, documented in the Bible. Read.
Give ear unto the law of our God, ye people of Gomorrah.
Because I know some of you Sodomites are out here. Y'all walking up and down the street somewhere. I saw a few of you earlier. But read on.
To what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifices unto me, saith the Lord?
Because some of them go in and out the church and they say they love God too. So God said, what's the purpose of your sacrifices? What you praying for me? What you giving your little offering for?
Bring it up.
Read.
I am full of the burnt offerings of rams and the fat of fed beasts. And I delight not in the blood of bullocks or of lambs or of he goats. When you come to appear before me, who hath required this at your hand to tread my courts?
God says, who required you at your hand to tread my courts? In other words, get the hell out of here with that abomination. God is not of sodomite, sodomism, homosexuality, transgender, Black Lives Matter for that. Read.
Bring no more vain oblations. Incense is an abomination unto me.
God says, I don't even want them homos praying to me. Read.
The new moons and Sabbaths, the calling of assemblies, I cannot away with. It is iniquity, even the solemn meeting.
Because they even create their own holidays. They have Pride Month. Ain't that the month of July? Ain't this their Pride Month?
I believe so.
This is their Pride Month. God says, do it away with it from me. Read.
Your new moons and your appointed feasts, my soul hateth. They are a trouble unto me. I am weary to bear them. Wash ye, make ye clean. Put away the evil of your doings from before mine eyes.
So that's what you gotta do, Tristan. God wants you to wash yourself and clean and put away the evil doing from his eyes.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.